Thank you. As you know, President Trump has displayed a casual indifference to the law in general, but nowhere is this more striking than in his use of the presidency for his own personal and private profit. In our call for an impeachment investigation, we have focused on two specific violations of the United States Constitution that we know for a fact that President Trump is in violation, and just as importantly, that these are well established as grounds for impeachment. And when we talk about the corruption of the presidency, it's easy to get lost in technical terms like emoluments. And as a lawyer, of course, I'm happy to do that. But it's important to understand that what President Trump is doing by enriching himself through the presidency is not only unconstitutional, it's not only immoral, but it's actually fundamentally corrupting of the republic to profit from the presidency at public expense. And he's doing this in two main ways that violate specific provisions of the Constitution. The first is by taking money from foreign governments. The founders of the Constitution were actually quite concerned about federal officials being influenced by payments from foreign states, and they put a provision in the Constitution known as the Foreign Emoluments Clause or the Foreign Corruption Clause that specifically prohibits these types of arrangements. The second category is enriching himself from the public treasury. And again, the founders may not have anticipated every particular angle of the president's grift, but they did put a provision in the Constitution. And it's called the Domestic Emoluments Clause, or also known as the Presidential Compensation Clause. It provides that the president is paid with a fixed salary that's set by Congress for his entire term of office and not a penny more. But what President Trump is doing is using the treasury as a kitty for travel to his own resorts and hotels and rent in his buildings so that he can enlarge his salary from the treasury without complying with this provision of the Constitution. Now, to be sure, not every violation of the law or even of the Constitution is necessarily grounds for impeachment. The standard in the Constitution is that president can be impeached for treason, bribery, or other high crimes and misdemeanors. It's ultimately up to the Congress to determine what count as high crimes or misdemeanors, but as we have cited in the legal analysis at the impeachdonaldtrumpnow.org website, the founders of the Constitution were actually quite clear on this specific point. One of the leading founders, Edmund Jennings Randolph, who was confronted at the Virginia Ratifying Convention with an argument against adoption of the Constitution on the grounds that the president might be too powerful and too subject to outside influence, cited these provisions, the Foreign Emoluments Clause and the Domestic Emoluments Clause, and said, if discovered, he may be impeached. That's where we are now. I want to close with a note that the examples of impeachable violations that we've cited in the legal analysis at impeachdonaldtrumpnow.org and that I've talked about today may not be the end of it. In the coming weeks, we will be working with our distinguished legal advisory board, which includes Professor Ross, and which you can see on the impeachdonaldtrumpnow.org website, to update that analysis, considering what President Trump has done so far in office. And of course, once an impeachment investigation is launched, Congress may decide to expand the scope. Thank you.